you just, you can't imagine. There were many days where I would walk to and from the hospital and look down at my feet and think, this really isn't me in this situation. So it's a situation that you never ever think you're gonna be in until you're in it. My name is Shannon Bogren, and I'm honored and grateful to work at NISC. So when my son Jameson was a senior in high school back in 2015, we noticed that he was sleeping a lot. He had gotten in an accident, had rear-ended someone. We decided to take him in on a Thursday to see his regular doctor's. Blood work came back, and on Friday, we went to the ER, had a CAT scan and didn't think anything of it. Doctor came in, it was one of those things that you never want to hear, and said, doctor said, your son has a large brain tumor. We can't do anything here in Bismarck, we have to send you to Fargo. So we ended up going to Fargo on a Friday evening, and then on Saturday we were transported to Mayo Clinic, and it turned out to be a very aggressive form of brain cancer. When we were down at Mayo, we knew that he needed 6 rounds of inpatient chemotherapy, followed by 6 weeks of proton radiation in Rochester, Minnesota. They determined the beginning of May that he needed a major resection. So we were living down at Mayo for many days on end. We stayed in hotels a lot. During his major resection, we were there for almost 2 months. We came home for that summer, but then finished out his 3 cycles of chemo here in Bismarck, but then needed to relocate for 6 full weeks for the proton radiation. So we actually rented an apartment down there, and I was able to work part-time virtually while taking care of him during his radiation treatments. My team of coworkers had my back from the very beginning. My manager said, your job is here. You don't have to worry about anything right now except for taking care of your son. One of my coworkers did give my name to the benevolence committee. And, you know, with the number of trips that we were making to Rochester, I think in 1 month we made 6 or 7 trips, staying in hotels night after night. We got help from the benevolence committee, and without that, I think we would have really, really struggled, because you don't prepare for that. The help from NISC, the help from the benevolence committee really gave us a peace of mind, gave us a chance not to have to worry about the finances so much, but focus on our kid. Benevolence committee supported me when we didn't know, you know, what the next day would hold. So I can't thank NISC and the benevolence committee enough for what they've done for me, my family, for Jameson as a whole. He is in remission. The pediatric neurosurgeon told us that he had a 5% chance of living. He said he wanted to go to college to get his degree in mechanical maintenance. We didn't think he would be able to do it. First year he lived at home, he completed his first year. And the spring of his second year at BSC, he threw another surprise at us and said, I want to go on to school. So he just finished up his first year of precision machining at Wahpeton, NDSCS. He is home doing an internship. He is loving life. He is going on 3 years in remission. Really, life for him right now couldn't be any better.